thank you so much for watching. I'm Terry Sabelle Foy, and I'm actually here at the Fort Worth Convention Center making plans for our icing conference. So I'm here meeting in the ballrooms with my team, and we're planning the event, and I am so excited to invite you to this free event, Icing, October 24th and 25th, right here in Fort Worth, Texas, at the Fort Worth Convention Center. Now, this is a free event, like I said, but you have to register online or register when you get here, but we prefer you to register online so we can make plans for you. But get this, to the person who brings the most ladies, we are going to bless you with a check, a big fat check for $1,000. So it's worth it to not only invest in yourself by coming, but invest in your friends, your connections, your associations. Get them to this event because together you're going to grow to the next level. But you could win $1,000 for bringing the most friends. So make your plans now. And like I've said before, my special guest is Nancy Alcorn, and you are going to love her. My theme is Once Upon a Time. We're going to talk about changing the story of your life. You know, I recently received this letter. I was looking through several testimonies today, going through this folder of different reports from people who've written on the website. And I got this from a sweet girl named Rebecca in Michigan. Rebecca said, "I've heard you talk about dreams." She said, "I have a dream of being married. I'm 48 years old. I have a dream of owning my own home, but I keep being back in my parents' house. I have a dream of getting out of debt, but I ended up in the hospital and I'm still financially recovering from all those bills. I'm attending a local community college hoping to get an associate's degree, and I'm not good at finishing things." She said, "I want God to make my dreams come true, to get a good paying job, to be able to support myself, but also to bring a godly man into my life and to fulfill my destiny." Well, Rebecca, and those who are going through things like Rebecca, where at times you feel hopeless, you feel like, you know what? This is not how I thought my life would turn out. This is not how I want my story to end. You need to come to Icing because we are going to talk about making destiny decisions. You know, you can make decisions right now that can change the course of your life. So I'm talking to Rebecca, but I'm talking to others of you who've given up on your dreams, or you think, you know, look at my age, it's too late. It's not too late. It's time to make those decisions that are going to give you the story that you desire. And you know, this month on the podcast, I'm talking about success habits of dream achievers, and one of them happens to be gratitude. Gratitude is one of the greatest things that I could recommend for someone like Rebecca and for myself. Gratitude is one of the greatest habits that dream achievers apply in their lives. You know, successful people have successful habits. And you know, it's amazing how the secular world, the business world, they have tapped into this, you know, act of expressing gratitude and seeing how it brings positive results in their lives. But God is the one who came up with this. In fact, years ago, I was coming out of the hardest time I've ever been in my life, faced with challenges I'd never been faced with before, wanting to quit, wanting to give up, wanting to throw in the towel. And I heard a minister say this. They said, "Stop looking at all that you've lost and start looking at what you have left. And start praising God, thanking Him for what you have left." When you start offering praise and thanksgiving for what you have left, it begins to open doors in your life, open doors of opportunities, open doors of blessings. Now, when I heard that, I thought, you gotta be kidding me. What in the world do I have to be grateful for? At that time, my marriage was falling apart. I was at home. I was miserable. I was lonely. I was depressed. I was just, you know, just unhappy, to say the least. And I'm looking around thinking, you want me to express gratitude for what? But I made myself, and I will never forget, it was about 11:30, almost midnight at night. I go downstairs in my kitchen, my little girl's asleep, my husband and I were separated, and I started walking around that kitchen with my hands lifted, tears pouring down my face, and I just started thinking of what I was grateful for. And I said, "Lord, I thank you that I have a house. I have a house to live in, and I thank you for this house." And I just look around. "Thank you, Lord, I do have food in the kitchen. I may not know how to cook it, but I have food in the kitchen." And then I started thinking, "Lord, thank you for that precious little girl upstairs in her bed. I prayed for that baby, thought I could never get pregnant, but you gave me a little girl. Thank you for that, Lord. Lord, I thank you that I have a job. I thank you that I have a family, that I have a best friend. Things just started pouring out of me. I had so much to be grateful for. Well, every time I would make myself lift my arms and just start praising God, the sadness would begin to lift. The misery would begin to fade and joy would be released in my heart. Well, then I came across this scripture, didn't even realize this at the time, but Psalms 22:3 says, God inhabits the praises of his people. Now, inhabits is a big word, so I had to look it up. Inhabits actually means he lives in, he dwells in, and he abides in the praises of his people. What does that mean? When you praise God right there in your kitchen, in your car, in your living room, in your bathroom, when you praise God, he lives in, he dwells in, and he abides right there with you. So you have just invited the presence of God, no matter where you are. Well, here's the other cool thing. 1 Chronicles 16:17 says, in his presence, there's fullness of joy. So you see the mathematical equation here? You lift your hands and start praising God, he's right there in your midst. In his presence, there's fullness of joy. It gets even better. Nehemiah 8:10 says, and the joy of the Lord is our strength. Well, what do you need when you're facing impossible situations, you're facing challenges, you're facing dreams that look like they're just not going to happen? You need strength. You need joy. You need the presence of God. How do you get those? Praise and thanksgiving. I'm telling you, this is a key to opening the favor of God in your life. This is a key to doors of opportunity opening up for you. If you'll just make yourself look around at what you have left and start thanking God for that, I'm telling you, you'll invite the presence of God, he'll bring joy, and joy will give you strength. And you know, in the Bible, we see how important thankfulness is to God. Do you remember the story of the 10 lepers? Remember, 10 lepers came up to Jesus and he healed them. Well, they all walked away. However, one out of the 10 turned back and said, Jesus, thank you. Jesus said, where's the other nine? The other nine took off. One came back and said, thank you. You know what Jesus said to him? Your faith has made you whole. The others were healed. In other words, you know, leprosy was a flesh-eating disease. Their nose might have been missing. Their ear was chewed off. Their elbows missing. But this guy, the one who was made whole, the nose grew back, the ear grew back, the elbow grew back. There was no sign he'd ever been a leper before. The others still looked like lepers, but the disease stopped. The one who offered thanksgiving, there were no signs he'd ever been a leper before. In other words, you can come to a place in your life where there's no sign you've ever been depressed, you've ever been divorced, you've ever had an abortion, you've never been bankrupt, you've never been homeless, you've never been hopeless. All because of thanksgiving. So I want to challenge you right now, when this podcast ends, just start thanking the Lord for what you have. And if you're enjoying these podcasts, please subscribe to this channel. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I love to keep you motivated to go after your dreams. Thank you for watching.